muganda waffe muwala waffe Belinda Munga ya Kiyenje. Program twabadde twagitadde ku mutimbagano obwolyawo mwasobodde okugiraba, naye we mubanga temwasobodde tugenda kubeera n'omukisa okubabuulira engeri gyegenda okutambulamu. Tweyanza nnyo Mukama abasobosezza okubeera wano, era twakutandika olunaku lwaffe luno olwaleero n'essaala. Muganda waffe Belinda yasabiranga mu watoto, tuyina abasumba okuva mu watoto abagenda okutukulembera mu kusaba akawungezi ka leero. Banaamaliriza emikolo egyo, tujja kubeerayo ne speeches entonotono n'omukisa okwongera okubabuulira ku programu nga bwenaabeera. Ng'omusumba bw'ajja okubajjukizaako nti olunaku lw'enkya tulinayo okusaba mu watoto North, then n'okuwerekera muganda waffe gy'anaawummulira e Nakasajja. Enteekateeka zonna twazitadde mu program gye tubadde tuweereza, era tugenda okufuba okuziyitamu akawungezi ka leero. Mu programu yaffe twateeseteese okusaba nga kwakutandika saawa emu n'era okumpi obudde bwebo. Katwanirize omusumba waffe atutwale ku kiddako, n'oluvannyuma tunaababuulira engeri gye tugenda okwasaganyamu obudde obunaddirira. Mwebale nnyo okukkiriza kujja kutukungubagirako. Mukama abaddizeewo era muganda waffe Belinda Mukama eyongere okumuwummuza emirembe. Mwebale nnyo.
Started with a word of prayer. We are going to go into worshiping our God. The one thing we know, even when we have lost a dear one, we still have reasons to give thanks to God. At least we are here, we are breathing, and He is good. He is still a good God. So let's get started with a word of prayer. And I'm going to request if we can raise on our feet. Tuyimireko kumaguru gafe. Mighty King, we come to you this evening. Our hearts are heavy because of losing our dear sister, daughter, Belinda. She is your daughter, and we know you have called her back to you. She is actually seated at your feet and enjoying your presence. So this side, we are mourning because we have lost her. We are not going to see her again, but we choose to celebrate her life. So as we meet this evening, and as we share good memories of the things we have shared with our friend, our daughter, our niece, Belinda, Mighty Father, come and be with us, Mighty God. It is only you that can comfort us. It is only you that can give us the strength that will keep us going. So come and have your way. We choose to focus on to you. For those who look to you, their faces are radiant and will never be covered in shame. So come and take charge. There is nothing that is going to happen here apart from you. We choose to focus on to you, Mighty God. Each and everybody, we are yours because we are created by you. And the reason you created us is to just have a relationship with us. So we offer ourselves as a living sacrifice as we worship these songs together. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us sing together these songs. And we are going to be led by Uncle D and my sister here.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. So great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto thee. Summer and winter and springtime and harvest, sun, moon and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new masses I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. And pardon for sin and a peace that endureth. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside.
So we sing,
great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
Mukama waffe yeebazibwe. Abalindirira Yesu tebawangulwa. Amina. Abalindirira Yesu tebawangulwa. Olwensi n'ebwebe lekaye tebamuduka. Abalindirira Yesu, abalindirira Yesu tebawangulwa. Sinebwebekaye, sinebwebe lekaye tebamuduka. Linda Yesu, linda Yesu, linda Yesu, yali namani o agayamba, agayamba abakoye. Linda Yesu yo, ekisache ekisa tochinyoma, chirina amanyi, chirina amanyi okulokola abo n'okubawonya. Linda Yesu,
linda Yesu, linda Yesu, yali na amani
agagayamba,
agagayamba abakoye. Linda Yesu yo,
atukuma yetakowa.
Atukuma yetakowa.
Era teyebaka, era
teyebaka.
Obwe sigwabwe.
Obwe sigwabwe. Chechigofe. Mwetu kwe kewa
Linda Yesu,
Linda Yesu, Linda Yesu, Yari na mani. Linda Yesu,
Linda Yesu,
Linda Yesu, Linda Yesu, Yari na manio.
Linda Yesu yo, o agayamba,
agayamba,
abakoye. Linda Yesu yo.
Father, we come to you. We are actually here waiting for you. For if you do not come, mighty Father, we don't know what to do. But because you are so faithful, you are so loving, you are a loving God. You are always by us. Actually, you are God with us, God Emmanuel. And when we sing these songs, we know you are here. Mighty Father, where two or three are gathered in your name, there your presence is. Mighty Father, we know you are with us here, mighty God. And as we wait upon your presence, come take church. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Njaba sabatu tuleko katono, ngabwetu betusoma echawa ndikibwa. Peter, you are going to read for us. If you could come in the light, I believe.
Today, I'm going to be reading from Psalm 46, chapter 1, Psalm 46, from verse 1 to 5. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth gives way, though the mountains be moved into the heart of sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble at its swelling. There is a river whose stream makes glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved.
Thank you so much. God is our refuge. For indeed, when we run to him, we are safe and we will be saved. We are going to read the second scripture. Please come and read for us.
I'll be reading from Philippians chapter 1, verses 20 and 21. Verse 20, I eagerly expect and hope that I will in no way be ashamed, but will have sufficient courage, so that now as always Christ will be exalted in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, to live is Christ, and to die is to gain. That's the word of God.
Thank you.
Let's stand up and sing this beautiful hymn, "It Is Well With My Soul."
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll,
tuyimirireko ku magulu gaffe.
Mu kiseera kino tumanyi kiseera kya kusoberwa nyate, bwe tukuŋŋaana mu ngeri efaanana bw'eti ne tuwulira ennyimba ezisitula emyoyo n'okutendereza Katonda waffe atuddamu amaanyi. Kale twagala okwebaza bannaffe abazze okutukulembera mu kiseera kino, naye twagala okusooka byonna okusabira famire ya munaffe Belinda, bannaffe omwami n'omukyala Bakajoba ne famire yonna, bannaffe Bakiyenje ne famire yonna, atera weewaawo ne bakadde ba Belinda muli nsonga zonna zonna. Kale taata omuyinza w'ebintu byonna, tuli mu kifo kino ekitugumya bwe tuwulira ennyimba zino ate n'ebitundu nga bisomebwa ebikwogerako gwe Katonda, tuddamu amaanyi n'okuguma emyoyo, kubanga obulamu buno bwe tulina tumanyi nti Mukama obulamu butandika naawe ate era bukomekereza naawe, kubanga gwe Alpha ate era gwe Omega. Kale bw'otyo Mukama waffe bwe wasalawo okuleetwa Belinda mu nsi n'omuteekerateekera ennaku z'agenda okumala mu bulamu obw'ensi eno, era ekiseera kye bwe kyatuuse ku lunaku lwe wateeka ku kalenda yo olutasobola kukyuka, Boto tata nosalawo okutwala Belinda mu ngeri gye wamututte. Naye nga abakyali mu mubiri guno, abazadde ba Belinda, famire zino zonna, abooluganda n'ab'emikwano, ate ne Belinda gy'abadde asabira gy'abadde afunira fellowship. Tata tetulema kutya na kweralikya n'ebibuuzo ebingi ennyo. Naye Mukama ekitugumya nti era ebibuuzo bibeerawo. Era ffe tetulina ansa, naye tumanyi nti omwana wo Yesu Kristo bwe yafa ku musaalaba e Golgotha yayogera ebigambo ebyo n'agamba nti kiwedde. Kaakati ye alina eky'okuddamu ku buli kibuuzo kyonna kye tuyinza okwebuuza. It is your son Jesus Christ who can give and provide the right answers. So that's why we want to focus to him at a time like this. So it's our prayer, blessed Father, as we continue in your presence, as we celebrate the life of our daughter, the life of our friend, the life of our cousin, in any relationship, we pray that, Father, you visit with us. Visit your children in this time, Lord. It may be a time of celebration, but it's a time of mourning, because we have lost the one we have loved. But it's only you, blessed Father, who can come and fill that space. So we invite you, Lord, that you be with us. We invite you, blessed Father, and say, visit us, Father, visit this family, the way you visited Mary and Martha, the time they lost their brother Lazarus. And you comforted them, blessed Father. But our encouragement in all this is that Belinda knew you and served you all her life. And your mission has always been her priority. So we continue to focus to you as we celebrate, knowing that now Belinda is in a better life. Kale mukama jangu ogumya abazadde, jangu ogumya abooluganda n'ab'emikwano. Era n'enteekateeka zonna mukama tuziteeka mu mikono gyo. Kubanga Belinda wamumanya, tannabeera na buto lwa nnyina, n'omuleeta mu nsi, n'omukozeseza byonna bye yakola, n'omubeera okukwata ku bulamu bw'abantu ab'enjawulo. Mweyo musilaamu ng'agenda n'otunuulira omuwala omuto omulungi, naye nga yeewaddeyo okugenda to identify with the poor in the slums of this city. Kale no mukama waffe tukkiriza nti Belinda mission yagikola bulungi. Kati ali mu mikono gyo, jangu osangula amaziga g'abantu, obasibe ekimyu, obanyweze, ayi Mukama. N'akawungeezi konna tukatadde mu mikono gyo, n'ekiro kyonna okutuusa Mukama waffe omubiri gwa Belinda we gunaagalamizibwa mu kifo kye w'olimusanga kukuzuukira kw'abantu bonna. Naye nga tusabira famire eno, tujjukira n'abalala bangi Mukama, families ez'enjawulo eziviiriddwako abantu baabwe. Taata nabo tubajjukira, tubasabira. Ekiseera ekifaanana bwe kiti kibeere ekiseera eky'okusemberera n'okumanya nti gwe Katonda omuyinza w'ebintu byonna, nannyini bulamu abutandika era abukomekereza. Naye kireme kubeera kiseera kya kwesitalako n'okudda emabega. Mukama waffe, abantu b'oluusi batya ne beeraliikirira ne divisions ne zijja, naye ebyo byonna tubisazaamu mu linnya ery'amaanyi ery'omulokozi waffe Yesu Kristo, nga tugamba Mukama ebiseera nga bino byongere kutusembeza kumpi naawe omuyinza w'ebintu byonna era nannyini bulamu. Beera wamu naffe Kitaffe w'ekisa, naye okusingira ddala otule ne famire eno mu linnya lya Kitaffe n'Omwana n'Omwoyo Omutukuvu. Amen.
Thank you so much, Bishop. Tujja basaba mutuuleko. Mwebale nnyo okujja. Tuli
So sorry for the interruption. We have an emergency and the drivers of these vehicles, kindly help us move them. UAA056M and UBM408Z. UAA056M, UBM408Z. So sorry for the interruption.
Thank you so much for coming this evening. Tutuse mu kiseera
ekyokuwaayo. We are going to give. We know a lot has been happening. Costs are up there and they have to be met. We are going to give. And when we give everything that is going to be given in here, we are going to make sure that it is handed over to the family to offset some of the debts, some of the costs that are ahead there. So tuja kusaba Uncle D, Uncle Dunstan. Tuinayo kubibo, Uncle Mark. So tugenda kufuna oruyimba ngabwe tufunayo kubibo, the baskets, and let's be generous. Let us give, like we said earlier on, we came to celebrate the life of our sister, friend, daughter, Belinda. And as we do that, let us sing together this song.
Okay. God holds the key to all unknown. Yesu byonna abimanye. Let's join in that beautiful Luganda hymn, Bisatu Asatu Mutanu. Yesu byonna abimanye. Yesu byonna abimanye. Chinsa nyusa. Antwala yeka mukubo seta gamu kule beze wabulaye wabulaye eliri ba wosibitia gantwa. Chinsani de, siza kwera birira ni mulafu, ankute mukono gwange, antambuza. Jari chamani ya echitalumbi kabali echirimu biene taka nempumula nempumula chevu sanyukira wambela nze erita izika jendi biasola vya malaye gwenja gala gwenja gala. Strength when I am weak, you are the treasure that I seek, you are my all in all. Seeking you as a precious jewel, not to give up or be a fool, you are my all in all. my strength. You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek. You are my only.
Seeking you as a precious jewel, not to give up or be a fool. You are my all in all.
Jesus, you are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek.
Thank you so much. Thank you for leading us into the praises and worship, for let everything that has breath in their lungs praise the Lord. And we will always praise the Lord, even when it doesn't make sense sometimes, but we shall always praise the Lord. So thank you so much for coming this evening. My name is Bonnie Kwilingira, and I come from Watoto Church, just near here, the one of Ntinda, near Chisasi roundabout. That's where I am coming from. And we came to identify with a family. Priscilla, we cannot say that we know what you are going through. We can only identify, we can only imagine, but we can't say that we know what you are going through. But Jesus would clearly understand what you are going through, because he went through it. He went through it. Auntie Diana and Mr. Kadu Mukasa Edward, thank you for being there for Belinda. Thank you for your involvement in these young people's lives. It makes a huge difference. And thank you for allowing us be here this evening. Thank you so much. I got to get this message, news, from Uncle D. In Watoto Church circles, when you say Uncle D, we will know him. He's one of our elders at Watoto Church. And when I got here, I had some people calling him Uncle Chisule. And Uncle Chisule, I think I'm calling you that name for the first time. We have always called him Uncle D. And we met and talked, and gave us a history of Belinda and where her life started. And we got to know, actually, she started at KPC, which later became Watoto Church. And I even heard from the bishop how she would be in the streets, in the slums, reaching out to those who needed to hear good news. I just want you to know that all of us want to hear the good news. When you see someone who has good news, you want to always be
near them. But if someone always has bad news, yeah, that person you always want to avoid them. Belinda was in the slums, and she did that. She could have chosen to have those good jobs where there is AC, and she serves maybe on a computer and sits in a car which has AC and goes back home to a home that also has AC. Those things are there. We know people who are like that. And actually, when such kind of people get to get involved with these other people who are less privileged, they sometimes don't identify. And as Belinda later on went to live in the States, I again got information that she would be on the streets preaching the word of God. And actually, not only giving the word of God, but where she was able, she could even go soliciting some funds so that she could be able to provide a warm meal to the ones that had less. So that's the person you came to celebrate today. So when we say that we have come to celebrate, indeed we have come to celebrate. Thank you for coming. And so that's how we come in as Watoto Church. We are, our vision is just a simple one. We are a cell-based community church. This is a community. The early church actually was, people used to meet in homes. That's how church began. And even when we were in COVID, someone wrote on social media and said they stopped us from going to church where we would meet on Sunday. But now every home, actually they are praying. So we now have many churches. And that's how the early church was. And so Belinda was at Watoto Church, KPC, and in a home cell. And when you start from a family base, when you start from a family life, nothing can ever stop us. Because when the family is doing well, the communities will do well, and the nation will be a stronger nation. So thank you so much for coming. And when we read, actually, Philippians chapter 1, verse 20, I just want to go to 21. For Belinda, to live is to Christ, and to die is to gain. Such a person has nothing to lose. She lived for Christ, and she knew what she stood for. She clearly knew it. If you know your purpose, you know why you are here, then you don't need to live for 150 years. Actually, Jesus died at 33, and he had accomplished what had brought him here. So sometimes we are fighting, we want to be here, and sometimes you can even be at 90, and you are still trying to discover your purpose. It's our prayer this evening that you go on your knees and ask God, what am I here for? The moment you get to discover what God created you for, you live a fulfilled life. So our sister, your daughter, your niece, Uncle D, she has lived a fulfilled life. A fulfilled life. So to live is to gain, is to Christ, and to die is to gain. Wow. And then we, Psalm 46, God is our refuge and strength. Yeah, sometimes you feel like, what can I do? Yes, within me, I can't do anything, but through him, to him all things are possible. And the moment we allow God to work through us, then we are going to find our strength, because he is the way, the truth, and life. All of us here want life. All of us.
just around Seragara stage to Koto. If I was running, it would take me about 10 minutes to get there. So nearby, I was invited by someone to go and pray for their mother. And I said, yeah, let's go. So we went, and as we were about to reach home, that's when it occurred to me. The person who is calling me to pray for their mother is about 79. So how old is the mother? That's when it occurred to me, because she was an old lady who called me to go and pray for their mother. And so I entered, and this lady was hitting 100 years. And I sat. She had her sight. She could see. She knew her daughter. She could talk. And one word she mentioned that changed my life. She said, and as you sang this song, and thank you for choosing it, we hadn't put it on our list, Linda Yesu. Because when you wait upon the Lord, I'll tell you this evening, those who wait upon the Lord, those who put their trust in the Lord, they are like Mount Zion, which can never be shaken, but stands forevermore. And she began telling me how her father now the one who is 100, clocking 100 years, is telling me about her father, how her father gave a piece of land to start up a church. And it was in that church that she would be told to go and sweep, and they would make mats to make people sit, and her brothers would just go and make benches. And she again went to that scripture. She didn't tell me it was a scripture, but later on I landed it on the Bible, Psalm 125. Those who put their trust in the Lord, they are like Mount Zion that can never be shaken. So even when storms come, that means if the storms will come, like now the storm has come to this family, but I want you to know where you put your trust in God, you will not be shaken. You shall remain standing. The storms will come. Like we hear this song that the foolish man built their house on sand and the wise on the rock. When the storm came, the other one crumbled down, the other one remained standing. So it's my prayer this evening, where have you put your trust? Is it in your education? Is it in your position? Is it in your bank account? Is it in your children? Or it is in the Lord? All things I have mentioned, they are good, but they come as secondary. The first is God. So Belinda knew this. She knew it. You may think that she has died. She has rested. She has rested. And she is before her father. And I can tell, well, I have not been in heaven before, but I can tell she's looking back and she's saying, I'm glad that one is there. I am glad that one is there. Yeah, we used to do this together. And I know when they cross over, when we cross that line, we shall be happy. And we shall, when Jesus is showing us the things we used to do, some things we don't know the impact. But Aunt Diana, you may not know the impact you did in this young lady's life. It can only be seen when you're on the other side and you are reading, and because I know there are books in heaven. At least that one I know. There are books in heaven. And as the books are being opened and they are showing you and they are showing you, and you'll be like, I'm glad I did that. And thank you. Thank you for doing that. Thank you for opening up your home to be a safe haven for them when they needed it.
Thank you, thank you. As I come to an end, where have you put your trust? Where? Because even the people who actually who have much, who have bodyguards, are the ones who want the armored cars. They are never safe. You have bodyguards, you have dogs, you have a perimeter wall, you need an armored car. What do you need? Meaning that where they have put their trust, they're not safe. So let's put our trust in the Almighty God. I'm going to pray, and I'm going to ask Uncle Mark. We did an offertory, we gave, we need to know how we gave. We shall be accountable before we leave. Okay, let us pray. As we are praying, I just want to ask you, I just want you to reflect. Without doubt, we know where Belinda is. Without a doubt. The track record shows. If your turn came today, where would you go? Because the truth is, we shall go. We don't know when, but we shall go. So I just want you to reflect. And if you really feel that you are far from your Creator, it's time to invite Him and make Him the Lord of your life. It is as simple as that. If you don't invite Him, He will wait until you invite Him. Father in heaven, as your children are here, we are here. You are our Father, mighty King. We invite you in our hearts. For those who could have wandered away, they have reflected. They are repenting and they are accepting you in their hearts. Come and have your way in our hearts, in our lives, mighty Father. The lives you have given us, we are just stewards of the lives you have given us. So this evening we've been reminded that those who put their hope, their trust in you will never be shaken. So mighty King, we surrender to your throne. We submit to your authority, mighty Father. As Belinda has come back to you, we did not actually apply that you give us Belinda, but you saw it fit and gave us Belinda, and you have seen it fit and you have called her back to yourself. She is in a place where there is no sorrow, no pain, and she is with you, mighty God. Now we want to pray for the family that is grieving, not because they are sad, because she's in a place where they don't know, but because we are not going to see her again. So that's where tears come in. But we truly know that she is in a better place. For the family, comfort them. For the family, give them that strength that they need. Keep comforting their hearts. The friends, keep comforting them, mighty God. Jesus, come and have your way. We believe you're with us. Because you are God who never leaves us. You are God Emmanuel. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for giving. We together, we've raised, collected 1,375,000. Uganda shillings. And I'll hand it over to Uncle Mark, because he's the one I'm supposed to, Auntie Diana. Okay. I'll be handing over to the MC and Uncle D. For the church service has now ended. The one word I want you to go with, where have you put your trust? Where have you put it? If it is in the wrong place, bring it back to God for He cares and he knows what we go through.
So as we are ending the service, we are going to hymn, to sing, not to him. Yeah, we are going to hymn a song. We are going to sing one hymn, 343. Nsanyukira ekigambo kino as my nephew, Ezra.
Nsanyukira
ekigambo kino, Yesu Mukama atwagala nnyo, alina bingi ebinsanyusa, n'ekisinga nti nze nkwagala, anjagala, anjagala. Ngakitalo kunjagala, anjagala olw'ekisa kye, nange amwagala. Bwe mba nyonoona ne mwerabira, Yesu tandeka kubula ddala. Ampita nange kulwayinaye, era nzijukiza kwagala kwe.
Anjagala,
anjagala, anjagala, nga kitalo kunjagala, anjagala olw'ekisa kye, nange amwagala. Bwenditunuulira ekitiibwa kye, ndiyimba ntya bwe siyimba bwentyo, nyimba emirembe n'emirembe, Yesu kikye kyakunjagaza nze.
Anjagala,
anjagala, anjagala, nga kitalo okunjagala, anjagala olw'ekisa kye, nange mwagala. Anjagala nange mwagala ye, yakka ku nsi olw'okwagala kwe. Kwagala kwamuleeta ku muti, Yesu watwagala ffe bwagazi. Anjagala, 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 nga kitalo okunjagala, anjagala olw'ekisa kye, nange mwagala.
Anjagala,
anjagala, anjagala, nga kitalo okunjagala, anjagala, anjagala olw'ekisa kye, nange mwagala.
Thank you so much, Bishop Motebi and Pastor Bonnie, for the wonderful and encouraging messages that you've given, and insight into the life of our sister, our friend, our daughter, Belinda. Okay, so the plan we have for the rest of the evening is we thought we would use this time to share our memories about our friend Belinda. So we shall be inviting our people to say one word or two. To say one word or two about Belinda. As you feel led. But what we are going for now is we are going to have a meal, call it dinner or supper, a meal. Now, the presentations or the words of encouragement shall come after. We have put in place arrangements for collecting contributions towards the final journey of our friend. For those that want to send the money electronically, on the screens is a number that you can send the money to. For those whose numbers are not in their names, it would be lovely if you could include your name in the message so that at an appropriate time, we can thank you. For those that have the money physically, near the public address system, we have a lady that is receiving the money. We are going to have, I don't know what to call them, DJ, the person manning the public address system to give us some appropriate songs as we try to prepare the meal. We shall have the meal and continue with our program as I had earlier informed us. Once again, thank you all so very much for standing with us and for coming to comfort us this evening. God bless you all. stories that they would want to share that will shed more light on who Belinda was to them and to all of us, kindly move forward and share with us. I saw one of Belinda's former roommates at campus in Mary Stuart. Now I can't see her anymore. But anyone that has something to share with us, please come forward and share the same. Thank you.
And all those who are our OGs on campus, please come forward. It's a big group of us. Guys and ladies, please come. Abakungu bazibona bali wano. Abakulu bekanisa. Abakungu bonna abali mu kifo kino. Tunakuwadde wamu namwe aboluganda, our relatives, Belinda's relatives, friends, Sila, Belinda's aunties, uncles, Uncle D. We stand here as people who have known Belinda. Some of us, we knew her since she was a little girl of about 9, 10. So each and every one of these ladies here has known her in that aspect. Okubanga chali mwala mto. And I'll say one or two things, and since this evening is freestyle, I think we can even speak, every one of us can speak until morning, but I'll say one or two things. I'll mostly say, as her roommate on campus, I knew Belinda from primary school, but I personally got to know her more when we interacted on campus. And Belinda was a lovely girl. She was really a lovely girl, and she loved the Lord. But one of the things that I remember that struck me about her, she was, I remember when we got into campus, we were all very excited about joining campus. You know, some of us who had been from only an all-girls school, seeing boys and all these things, knowing that it's going to be an exciting time. But then it was quite surprising that when we got onto campus, Belinda had a job, she was doing some gig somewhere, And she was actually a very busy girl. And it really struck me that she had already organized her life at such a very young age. And before I knew it, she was, apart from that gig, she also did a business. Just know that within that short time, for a girl her age, she had achieved so much. Well, by then, I could say she had achieved so much. And she was thinking way more mature than, you know, the rest of us. Okudda mu Luganda, twali tulowooza ku bintu, you know, tugenda, we are going to have fun, we'll go every weekend and have fun. But this was a girl who was very focused. So she would excel in class, but she was also very enterprising. And for me, that really became an inspiration. People normally say these things, but for me, that is one thing I remember. And I remember also starting like a small thing that I could afford because of Belinda. I started a small thing. And for me, that was quite an inspiration. And later when she told us about the school, because she called up many of us and told us about the school, please bring your children. And by then, I think she was about 30-something, maybe about 33, 32. We were all still relatively young. But from the history of how enterprising and how hardworking and how focused she was, to me, it wasn't really surprising that she could actually reach such a milestone. And I remember, I think I even posted this. I have a friend who once told me that, you know, if you're always ahead of your peers, you always remain ahead. So for me, at the age of 33, for someone to own a school, I actually thought, hey, this girl is just, you know, she's just made of another kind of fabric. Wait, she was just way ahead of us. And it may seem like Belinda has gone quite early, but I think she has accomplished so much. And from the stories that people are giving, she has really accomplished much more than many of us have accomplished at her age. And we thank God that at least there's testimony that she loved the Lord till the very end. We give glory to the Lord for that, and because of that, you know that we're actually celebrating that she is in heaven. And not to make another sermon, but I hope that the testimony of her life shall also be a challenge to the rest of us who are here. And when we're having the vigil about 2.5 weeks, I think it was about 2 weeks ago, from the testimonies of how she used to pray for people on the street, we were in the chats, we kept saying, my God, this was an amazing lady. She kept the faith to the very end. When we're in school, they used to make jokes that guys or girls get saved for a week, and the next week, you know, they're back and we go back to chapel, praise God, I'm saved again. But it's amazing that someone actually kept the faith into her 40s. Until death, she was still professing God. We heard from Enid, who was with her, that even before she died, she was professing God's goodness, and she knew where she'd be going. And for that, we really praise God and celebrate her. And I think that's what I'd want to say about Belinda. I'll give to my friends who are here with us. They would want to say something about Belinda. Thank you very much.
Good evening to you all. We praise the Lord for Belinda's life. My name is Janet. I'm also one of the people who went to Gayaza Junior School with Belinda, and most of these ladies were together. Belinda joined us in P4. That was in 1991. She was a small little girl. Like Kathy said, she could have been about 9 or 10. And she joined us from Lesotho. We used to say, Belinda, it's Lesotho. And she would say, no, guys, it's Lesotho. So we had very good ex- experiences with her. She came when boarding school was really tough. Most of these ladies can testify. Gaza Junior wasn't easy back then. I don't know about it now. But personally, when I was thinking about Belinda's life in Gaza Junior School, it felt like she had been baptized by fire. She had to learn many things. She had to learn to wash for herself. She had to learn to clean, to sweep. We used to do a lot of work, but with support from us all who were with her, Belinda managed to sail through. The hardships were many. I'm sure some of her family members know their stories, but she managed to pull through. Belinda loved to learn so many things. One of the things she wanted to learn very much was Luganda. She didn't know how to speak Luganda. So we taught her some Luganda words. And for me, I specifically remember that there's a Luganda song she really loved. It was called Obudenga Bunatero Kucha Oteganga Matuno Ulira Nyonyizo Kunsi Ngabwezi Imba Gazi Tendereza Oyo Oyo Oyali Wagulu. So we used to sing that song. And I believe right now Belinda is praising the Lord she used to praise back then. And I'm glad that seeds of the gospel were planted in her heart, in her spirit, at a tender age. Belinda was very excellent. She joined us when she was very good at mathematics and English. But she had struggles in social studies and science. But by the end of our P4, she was among the top students. And that showed that she was very hardworking. She asked questions. She wanted to learn. She wanted to excel. And I think that is a virtue she's continued to live up to, even at the point of her death. Then we moved to P5. When we moved to P5, Belinda's leadership skills started showing. And that's the time that teachers believed she was worth being a head girl. So by P5 third term, Belinda became a head girl. And we loved to hear her talk. She had that very nice American accent. She used to move like a little lady. She was neat, well kept, and she continued to also excel in academics. So teachers saw something good. Back in the day, we didn't have campaigns like our children have right now at their schools. The teachers would have a meeting and choose whoever was fit for whichever position. So Belinda managed to win the hearts of our teachers, and she became our head girl. And she served her term well. Some of us here served with her as prefects. And she led us well. We didn't have any, you know, issues with her. We loved to listen to her, give us instructions, talk to us, address assemblies. She was very eloquent. She was a super girl. Finally, we completed our primary level in 1994. Guys, it's okay. So, and Belinda excelled. She got a super 4 and was able to join Gaza High School on merit. Those days you just sit home and your name is up on that list. You would struggle, you know, parents benching, no? So she managed to excel and she did very well. So when we joined high school, then we met more ladies that you see here. And so Belinda now started thriving more and more and more. Maybe before, someone else will talk about her high school experiences. But before they do so, Belinda called me about 2 weeks before she passed on. And there are things she wanted to know. So we had a little talk. But one of the things I remember, she kept asking me about so many of these ladies. Where's so-and-so? What is she doing? Do you have so-and-so's contact? How can I get in touch? So for me, when I look back, when we got to know that Belinda had passed on, I asked myself, why was she asking me about everybody and everyone and what's happening in their lives? And it hurt me so deep. She really wanted to connect, maybe at a deeper level with us as individuals. And I felt that was something very good. And for me, what I picked from that was to be intentional at keeping our friendships, at checking on people, at finding out what's going on, and maybe being able to stand with everybody. So it's sad that she had to leave us. But to the family, we pray that the Lord continues to comfort you and to share those beautiful memories that you had with Belinda, knowing that she's in a better place. Praise the Lord.
MC, we are going to come back. For now, let's take a break and give a chance to other people. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, ladies. Our fellow mourners, as we had earlier intimated to you, the people that have prepared a meal for us have informed us that they are ready to minister to our spirits through our stomachs. And so we are going to access the service points with the guidance of our teams, the ushers. They are going to lift us up in a timely manner and an orderly manner. UAS 525. There's something. There's no alphabet after that. UAS 525S. So the driver of UAS 525S, please help us and move your vehicle. You're blocking someone. Our ushers, can you please come and collect people so we can begin the next process?